Stewart to the puck. Mantha trying to work it free. Puck comes to Zetterberg, but a Detroit penalty. Spurgeon remains down.
Yeah, it was Nyquist that got the stick up on Spurgeon. Battling with Chris Stewart. Jared Spurgeon comes in and gives him a shot. Nyquist doesn't like it. Watch Nyquist. Retaliatory play on Jared Spurgeon. You have to be in control of your stick. To me, that's one of those where you throw the guy right out of the game for a play like that. Getting
things out a little bit. Continue to scramble. Now Gudas in there too, so it's 3-on-3. Now Gudas has his helmet. Oh, Gudas with a chop at the helmet of Perreault, and that was spotted.
You need to take one more look at it. There's, watch Perreault, 85 in blue, as he spins off of Ratko and then ends up taking the helmet off of Ratko. Gudas right there, and then Ratko comes down with the stick on the side of the head.
And we'll wait and see. It looks like they pointed to the Philadelphia bench like they may be taking him out of the game. They are. Gudas is being sent to the locker room.
Candela up the boards, but Hossa intercepts. Back to the point and across for Jalmerson, but the pass brings Jalmerson out of the zone. Coyle was hit up high by Duncan Keith, but there's going to be a penalty here against Chicago. Coyle is cut on the play. And this looks like it'll be more than just 2 minutes against the Hawks defenseman.
For a reason. Well, McSorley is out there as well. Oh, McSorley slashed for Scheer and caught him in the helmet. Wow. Donald Brashear is down and maybe out. Now with 2.7 seconds, and Garth Snow has gone after McSorley.
Boy, I tell you what the ugly part of this is what's being thrown on the ice.
Well, Marty went over and leaned over and said something to Brashear as he was laying on the ice. I don't think it was, I hope you're okay.
Johansson fighting with Scheifele. And then he knocks Scheifele down, spinning around. And it'll be a penalty against Johansson. It's unfortunate. It looked like Johansson was getting held and yanked. And he's turning around trying to get freed. And the stick hit him over the top of the head.
They're just going in the corner, battling, as they always do. You can see each guy grabbing, trying to fight for that puck. And then Johansson coming around, trying to get position and just tomahawks him on the top of the head unintentionally. But he came down awfully hard. And
a warrant has been taken out for the arrest of Dino Ciccarelli. The charge is assault under Section 245 of the Criminal Code.
First whack by Ciccarelli right up at the face area, and now comes down on the back of the neck. And finally another one before he drops his stick.
The rebound, and Ciccarelli was hit the side of the neck.
Hurt, Jeff. He got hit right in the face.
And he was hit very hard. He is down and in a lot of pain. Dino is really upset talking to Carey Frazier.
Well, that's a definite five-minute major, Jeff.
Without question.
That's a flagrant use of his stick. And then the cross-check. Automatic five-minute major and game misconduct, no doubt about it. But even if he didn't, that's an automatic five-minute major. He talked to their linesman. No one saw the play. If you didn't see the play, you still got to call that a major penalty.
Header back in front. Carter with a left-hand shot. And Crawford makes a save on him. Stahlberg ahead to Bickle. And Brian Bickle works his way ahead.
Oh, Duncan Keith just turned around. One-handed slash. Jeff Carter right in the mouth.
So Keith was reaching for his glove. Carter got tangled up with him, and Keith just gave it to him with the stick.
Here's the penalty here. So Carter slashes Keith, and Keith just takes a stick and whacks him right in the face. Now, I'm pretty sure by Keith's reaction, it's not what he intends to do, but nonetheless, he smacks him right in the face with his stick. He picks up a double minor.
To get there with his speed, and he got that chunk, sidestepped that check beautifully. And the Flyers clear the zone, and now, behind the play, heavy contact, Jesse Bolarice dropped his stick, and the Canucks want action.
A Canuck is down on the ice. I believe it's Kessler. He is not moving.
Let's see if we can pick it up. Here comes Boulderese. Here comes Kessler, and there's Boulderese. And he got him pretty good. He got him real good. Got him with a cross check right across the face.
Around. Galchenyuk is there. He's met by Kevin Miller. Beck is trying to move the puck. Raguilov. Can't get it by Marchand. Marchand is on it, cruising out down the ice. Galchenyuk back to the play. Got tangled up with Kevin Miller. Miller is down and hurt. And a penalty coming up here to the Canadians. It'll be a high sticking call against Galchenyuk, and he's going to draw some attention from Bergeron. Miller. Colin Miller. Involved in that.
Going down, and he gets tied up in the corner with Miller. There's the cross check. He loses his balance. When he's going back into the boards, the stick comes up. Now watch Galchenyuk right at the bottom of your screen. Gets hit, and the stick comes across, and well, the follow-through as well. And he did lose balance, but you are responsible for the actions of your stick.
Gets away from Brown and tried to go for the net, and he's tripped up. No call. Hextall trying to move his man in front. He makes the save with Sandstrom right there and holds on, and Sandstrom is decked. Dave Brown blindsided Sandstrom, knocked him down.
The edge of the crease. Howe has got him covered. However, Sandstrom got a stick on that puck. And you can see Hextall came out there, but then Brown, what a shot. And we spoke so highly of him before. That is just a dumb penalty that can cost his team this hockey game.
Bocoon made the save. He couldn't find it. And Bocoon is down in his net. I believe Keith Ballard broke his stick and it may have caught Bocoon in the head. And Bocoon is bloodied. Oh my goodness. What happened there after the play? Oh boy.
He's going to get a better look at what happens. Oh.
Yikes.
He went to bank it off the post and just... Talk about adding insult to injury.
And they've got a stretcher out on the ice here for Bocoon, who is down. That stick, obviously, hitting Bocoon in the head. I mean, no one's got to feel worse in the building than Keith Ballard. I mean, here it is. Ballard out of frustration, going to hit the goalpost, and catches Bocoon.
Square on that
right
side.
Right in the, I mean, wow.
Ryan Holick, he loves to run it, guys. He runs at Chris Simon. Simon gets up, and he gives him the lumber right in the face. Simon chops him right across the chin. Holwig goes down. He would get up, go to the bench. He'd stay in the game. Simon, he was tossed.
Oh, gosh. What was that all about? You see the blood coming out of the nose of Steve Hines.
Collides with Chicago's Neil Wilkinson. Now, after the collision that's just coming up, you'll see Granato take a two-handed swing. He'll now tell Brian Burke some of the things he told us today.
And lastly, in a stick-swinging duel, Wayne Mackey of the St. Louis Blues strikes Ted Green of the Bruins in the head. Green suffers a compound skull fracture, has two brain operations, and a plate put in his head.